What's up, y'all? I'm Marcus. Welcome back to the Armor Guide. This is part two of the heavy armors. Please note that a lot of the armor in this video will affect your stamina recovery rate. Check the intro video when it's done to the Armor Guide for more details. Use the links below to skip to the armor you're interested in, blah, blah, blah. Tidal Wave! The Giant's armor is both the most loved and hated armor in the game. It's easily available. You can simply buy it from the Giant Blacksmith in Orlando. It's extremely heavy and has a shit ton of poise and defense. When fully upgraded, it has ridiculous physical defense in particular. Many people like to use this set in PvP in combination with Havel's Ring and the Dark Woodgrain Ring, and a build stack with Vitality and Endurance. They can flip around like a ninja, they have a ton of HP, and thanks to the use of elemental weapons, they can still deal decent damage without increasing stats like Strength or Dexterity. If you are just worried about your kill-death ratio, this sort of setup will carry you against many players. Wearing it does carry a stigma though. It kind of stigmatizes you as being the sort of person who will do whatever it takes to win, glitch, gank, things like that, spawn camp, all sorts of stuff. It kind of has a stigma to it. Whether or not you choose to use it is up to you. Personally, regardless of effectiveness or reputation, I just plain hate the way it looks, so I don't use it. I also don't like Endurance Gouge builds, so I wouldn't even use it for effectiveness. I think you just give up too much utility, but that's just me. Havel's is kind of similar to the Giant set. It's heavy armor with good defense and highest poise you'll find. And speaking of finding it, it's in Havel's hidden cache in Orlando, so you just have to go through the fake wall there and be careful of the mimic guarding the occult club. It's mixed in with the other chests, so just don't make a mistake. At first glance, Havel's appears to be better defense than the Giant set, but Havel's can't be upgraded. Note that equipping the arms and legs will give you 56 poise, putting you at one of the important breakpoints, while allowing you to wear whatever you want for your chest and head slots. And poise breakpoint info will be found in this guide's introduction when it's completed. Note that it's mostly for PvP, but just consider using the gloves and legs to supplement your armor of choice. Ah, the holy set. This has one of my favorite helms in the game. It's so cool. Anyway, this is also known as the Cleric Armor, but it isn't the Cleric starting set. This is the one that's worn by Vince and Nico. You can buy it from Patches at Firelink Shrine. Now, I'm not sure of the exact trigger for this, his appearance at Firelink, but he always comes to Firelink for me after I kill Nito in the Tome of the Giants. So there you go. Kill Nito and he should appear at Firelink. I mean, unless you did something silly like killing him or whatever. This set is lighter than Giants and has less poise, but I like its style. It looks really good. Note that an Elite Cleric set does exist, but cannot be attained without hacking or having it gifted to you from a hacker. This is true as of 1.05, but may change in the new content. So, if you're a time traveler from the future, then kindly give me some stock tips rather than correcting this info. The Channeler's set can be found in the Duke's archives and... Yeah. If you love the Channeler set for some reason, then I'm sorry, because I just don't have much to say about this one. Wear it if you like to kidnap girls and read bedtime stories to blind albino dragons or something. The Silver Knight set is comparable to the Black Knight set from last time, although it is slightly inferior to its darker version. The Silver set is found for free, however, in Orlando, so you can actually get some use out of it before New Game Plus, unlike the Black version. To get the Black Knight set, once again, you have to go to the Kiln of the First Flame, which is the final area, so it's kind of useless at that point. The steel set is worn and sold by the vendor in Sin's Fortress. This is the armor worn by the Knights of the Berenike unit, or Bani suit, depending on whether you want to be all Japanesey easy breezy. The unit part that I'm throwing in there comes from my translation of the Kanji Dan. People always tell me Berenike was a person rather than a country due to one of the item descriptions, I think one of the shield descriptions. The truth is that the original Japanese text isn't clear if it's a place, a person, or simply the unit's name. It's not the only point where the English translation causes a bit of confusion, but whatever. The translation team did a fucking fantastic job. There's always going to be something. And they may have access to info that I don't. Who knows? Honestly, I'm leaning toward Berenike or Bani suit being the name of the group rather than a place or person. Tarkus may have been a special member. Once again, time traveler, stock tips, please. And finally, the stone set. It's comparable to the Giant's armor. It has better defense out of the box, but can't be upgraded. I speculated before that this was created in Ulusil, and that's all but confirmed now. Yay! There are two more videos remaining in the armor guide, special sets, and the introduction. Once again, I saved the introduction for last because I knew you ballers would ask some awesome questions, and you have so far. Current topics I'm planning for that are poise, stamina recovery penalties, and stylish combos. So if you have something else that you want me to talk about in the introduction to the armor series, please leave a comment and let me know. Also, check out the site I'm creating for a more organized format for all of these videos, as well as the lore fac and some other nifty little stuff. The link is in the description. As a channel update, I'm thinking about trying to maintain a weekly schedule of Tactics Tuesdays, Demonic Thursdays, and Dark Souls vids on the weekend. I'll also be picking up a new Japanese-only game, Anarchy, next week, and I'll probably do a preview vid for it, similar to what I did for Ni no Kuni and Musou Orochi. Just trying to keep y'all in the loop. Later, sexies. Oh, wait, one more thing. I received a very special series request for another channel, and I may be doing that if possible. More details when I know more, but it sounds like a fucking blast, so we'll see. Later, y'all.